Hello everyone and welcome to Let's Play Final Fantasy XIV Heavensward. I just wanted to let everyone know that I will not be doing voice commentary for the rest of this video series because I do not feel like it. And I just wanted to really show everyone the main story, so I'm going to be cutting a lot of the actual grinding out. So all the future videos are mostly going to focus around showing everyone the main story of the game. So I hope you enjoy watching the rest of the series.
One path, one bed, and three. The dawn's light will shine again. So long as we have these specious accusations hanging over us, we will struggle to achieve anything. You must go to Ishgard, as Tataru proposed. I will return to Uldar and set things right.
Pray, do not be so hasty, Master Alphino.
Lord Orchifon.
Full well do I understand your desire to clear your names. But now is not the time for drastic action. You yet have allies upon whom you can rely. There is no need to act alone.
Yes. Yes, of course.
I bring tidings. Count Edmont has decreed that the three of you be taken in as wards of House Fortan. Under our patronage, you shall be granted access to the city proper. Pray, consider our manor your new headquarters, from which you may gather information and plan how best to proceed. Needless to say, should any of your missing allies be found, as I am certain they shall, they will of course be welcome to join you there.
You are more than generous, my friend. On behalf of my fellows, I humbly accept your offer of hospitality.
The Count is a good man and just. He will treat you with the kindness and respect that a hero and dear friend deserves.
To Ishgard, then, together. There we shall carry on the Scion's legacy. There we shall begin anew.
Hear, hear!
So they came, at a friend's behest.
Oh.
heroes once celebrated as saviors of Eorzea, brought low through treachery, their names blackened with royal blood. With memories of the lost and dreams of redemption, with hope yet in their hearts, they came. To Ishgard, shining city on the mount, overlooking the dominion of Kurthus. A great and proud nation, devoted to Helone, the Fury, ruled by Thordin the Seventh, Archbishop of the Ishgardian Orthodox Church. The last bastion of the faith, her walls ever bristling with the sworn swords and spears of her four high houses. A land that after 1,000 years of war had forgotten what it was to be at peace. Through gates long closed, the Warrior of Light and her companions passed, entering at last a city whose history was written in blood. In the midst of the Dragonsong War, they came, three weary travelers whose arrival would set in motion great change. Though none knew then how great.
My lord,
I have returned with the Scions.
I hope your journey was not too taxing. I, Count Edmond de Fortomp, do bid you welcome. As wards of House Fortomp, you shall be afforded every courtesy. My home is your home.
My companions and I are deeply honored, Count Fortomp.
The honor is mine, Master Alfino. Consider it an expression of our gratitude for your service to Ishgard.
Forgive me, my lord, but are you not concerned? To accept foreign guests at such a juncture, especially ones with our reputation.
Do not worry yourself on my account. 'Tis true that Ishgard's first thought has ever been the war effort, hence the closing of our borders. Yet it is in troubled times most of all that men should seek allies, don't you think? Granted, my decision will have raised eyebrows in the vault and in the halls of the other high houses. But so long as you continue with your altruistic endeavors, I doubt my honored peers will feel moved to voice their concerns.
Then there is naught to fear. Though our numbers are much reduced, we are no less determined to carry on our work.
Full glad am I to hear it. But before you return to your labors, why not take a tour of the city? You would do well, I think, to acquaint yourselves with your new surroundings. After all, you may be here for some time. Upon an airship, conceived within the fecund mind of Sid Garland, renegade prodigy of Garlemald, who had come to call Eorzea home.
Thank you.
high into the heavens, where isles of earth and stone floated as clouds. A frontier the knights of Ishgard had scarce begun to explore. To a fledgling outpost within the sea of clouds, where careworn scouts ever scanned the skies for winged shadows, she came.
Thank you.